Hi everyone, a happy Pongal to every one of you who is celebrating. My name is Bini Singh and today I thought of updating you all about Seed 100, the work which we did in 2020 and the things that we are planning to do in 2021. 2020 has been a very challenging year for every one of us, and I think it has been harder on our children with the restriction to go out, not being able to attend their class, meet their friends, the mental health issues. But we have been in constant touch with all the 15 of the children that we support through Seed 100. We've been calling them, we'll be calling their parents or the local guardian and finding out if they are okay. So the first update is the five children whom we support in the boarding school in Santosha Vidyalaya, Tirunelveli. As soon as the Prime Minister announced the lockdown, the school had to shut down. And the school made arrangement for all these five girls to go back to their home, to their parents or to their local guardians, and we were updated on it as soon as they reach home. So they are fine, they are at home and they are doing schooling from their home. We spoke to all five of them, their parents, to find out if they had proper internet facilities and equipments to connect to their class. Pongal Payasam. The second and one of the happiest update that I wanted to give you was about Maria. Now, Maria is a girl who was given to us in 2017. And we got her admitted in Anna Adarsh College in Anna Nagar, Chennai. Now, few days back, my wife got picture of her working in a medical company, working with something to do with data. I still need to find out what exactly that is, but she has got a job where she gets paid properly. And she's independent, and that is what we Seed 100 is all about, finding out girls who wants to study and not able to study, get them into college and finding a job. And so this is our first success story. Maria finished her 12th standard in 2016, and from 2016 to 2017, that is one full year, she had to sit at home because she was financially not strong enough to support her education. Her relatives did not come forward to support her education. And through our friends, we came to know about her. We went around finding out which college she would want to study, and we put her in Anna Adarsh College. The college was really supportive, and today she is working. This is very big news for us, and this is maybe the first success story of taking a girl child, educating her, and putting her in a platform where she can, where she is independent. She has her own work. And it's really very happy news. Now the update number three is about a girl named Nirmala. This is not a very happy story, and we at Seed 100 are a little bit disappointed whenever we talk about this. There is a girl named Nirmala whom we found in a shopping complex working as a lift operator. And me and my wife, we decided that we'll support her. She has completed her 12th standard 2 years back, but couldn't go to college because her dad is an alcoholic, mom works in the nearby temple making some money. We went to her home. It's a small shed with six people living in one small room. Horrible condition. And that's why we thought, okay, we'll take Nirmala in and we'll support her. Jeremy, who is our treasurer, took the responsibility of her admission. He went and spoke to a few people in MCC, got her admitted in one of the course, which is related to, lab technician. The medical lab technician, where you take people's blood, analyze and stuff like that. Judging by the situation, I think she was very lucky to get into MCC. First year she did really well, and second year she showed some improvement in her studies. Me and Meena visited her college twice. We spoke to her teachers. By the mid of second year, we got a phone call from her teacher saying that Nirmala no longer comes to college. We were very disappointed because we have invested a lot in her. Time-wise, money-wise, care, we were like totally involved with her, and money as well. A lot of money went into her admission and her course. So it was a big disappointment for us. And also we were hoping that once she finished her college, we will help her with a job, and maybe she will help her family to come up. We went to her home to find out why she is not coming to college. We met her mom and her siblings, but it was beyond our, what do you call it, as we have a line where we cannot cross, and she was involved with some things which where I felt personally that we cannot get involved there. But I told her that if you want to come back to college, you have 1 year of time and you can come back. We did follow up with her. She did not come back. So in 2021, we have taken three more girls to support their college education. One is in South, in Tuticorin district, and two is in Chennai. So totally we have 15 girls. We have five in boarding school, five in college, and five in regular schools. In 2021, we are planning to stop taking a girl child to support in schools, and we are going to focus only on college. There are plenty of reasons behind that, and I'll talk about that in some other video. Last year, along with supporting this 15 girl child's education, we also supported 4,000 migrant workers. When the lockdown was announced, a lot of migrant workers were stuck in Tamil Nadu with no job or no money. Seed 100 took responsibilities of providing ration to 4,000 people in and around Talambur. We provided them with ration for 30 days. We arranged the transportation to the local railway station. From there, government has made arrangement through trains so that they could reach their hometown. A lot of you came forward to help us with the migrant crisis, and I cannot thank you enough. Your support and your contribution is bringing change in many people's life, and we are seeing that every day. Thank you so much. I'll see you again in the next video.